but the school must be utilized to its maximum by the children. We cannot build a high school and the children don't use it, don't utilize it.
People are not used to challenging government, but I must say to those of you, you have to learn how to speak up for your community, because here we have to fight for everything that we can get. And it is criminal for the city of New York to allow those children to ride public transportation to go to school at the age of 9 years old.
We had a movement then. There wasn't just a demand from an elected official, there was a movement. And we were desperate people. So what we finally did was shut down Ogden Avenue. We moved the old school desk out into Ogden Avenue, put teachers and students out there in Ogden Avenue.
We'll be open wide to all for the first time in nearly 40 years, who after years and decades of voicing their concerns came together to form a coalition in Highbridge, the Highbridge Coalition, which works relentlessly to see that the bridge was reopened and the communities of the Bronx and Manhattan united. Standing here at these doors, soon to open, we are all neighbors in Highbridge. We represent community members of organizations and institutions, and together we represent a Highbridge united. United for a better future for our children and for our community.
To the future.
The children, they have to stay in school. That's my main thing. You stay in school, and from there you could take music, you could do dancing, whatever you want to do, you can do it. But if you stay in school, that's number one thing, and stay in school. You are in school, you're in trouble.
A sign of advice is go to school, learn, read a lot of books. Whatever you like to do, you can do.
Sit down with a lot of the leaders and give them our ideas, and they share their ideas with us, you know. I think everything would work out much better.
Become a neighborhood. That's the biggest change. It's become a neighborhood, a neighboring community where people greet each other. It's a nice place to be.
It had its bad time in between the years, but it's coming back, and the people seem to be taking pride in their area and their homes.
Every neighborhood changes, and we have to adapt to the new people that come in.
We have this aqueduct that was there, was bringing the first fresh water to New York City. That's a big achievement, and this is not taught in the schools. So that's why this documentary is good for those reasons, for the way back historical reasons, for the current historical reasons, and for things in the future. And we do need to have some kind of record of it.
The importance of a documentary is simply the importance of having the high bridge in our community. A video is going to point out to all of us some assets that we have never been aware of.
And with the knowledge about what we used to have, and with the understanding of what we can have, hopefully this community can come together and make sure that those dreams that people had for the last 50 years can be obtained.
We want to improve the area and make it beautiful. When young people, who are presently in their teens, reach their 20s, they choose to live here and bring up their kids here.
They were people that were striving to do better. They were people that were part of family and part of a community. So the children that see this should recognize that they're part of history.
So this is their home. So they have to make it their home. And a home is what? Make it as much beautiful as you can be.